to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
So just really quick on the jobs for heroes, I know you're all at the host here at the breakfast this morning, but we're still going through the budget negotiations. The assembly has, at every turn, tried to gut the bill. So to the extent you can be helpful reaching out to your counterparts on the assembly side, I appreciate it.
Yeah. If I may, Mr. Chair, do you have left assembly member DiBenedetto?
Benedetto.
Thank you. And then I mentioned that they're pulling it out of the budget and they're going to vote for it on Thursday in the assembly.
As long as the wording.
Right. Exactly. So that remains to be seen what the bill looks like.
So hopeful.
Yep.
Yep.
Just keep, please keep your finger on it, okay? Okay. Let's start with 3886.
An act to amend the penal law in relation to soliciting and providing support for an act of terrorism.
Thursday is the governor's veterans. Thursday is about the governor's
This bill will serve as a strong message to criminals providing support to terrorists by increasing the penalties for each degree of credit card fraud. When the intent that material support or resources would be used in whole or in part to plan, prepare, carry out, or aid in either an act of terrorism or the concealment of or an escape from an act of terrorism.
Make a motion.
Move the bill.
Second. Good. All in favor? Opposed? Bill supported. 3892.
An act to amend the tax law in relation to establishing business franchise and personal income tax credits for employers who employ combat veterans. This bill will provide an employer with a $6,000 tax credit if they hire a combat veteran who's been honorably discharged or released under honorable circumstances from their service or full load to the reserve within 2 years from return to their service.
Questions on that?
Move the bill.
Sounds out right on that one.
Without ratification. Our next bill is 4759.
An
act to amend executive law in relation to requiring counties to maintain a confidential registry of people of all ages with disabilities for evacuation and sheltering during disasters.
All in favor.
Move the bill, except I'm without rec and Senator Gibson is out without rec. Okay.
I'm a nay.
I'm without rec, so I'll second.
4760.
An act to amend the tax law and state violence law in relation to establishing the Homeless Veterans Assistance Fund and authorizing gifts to such fund through a state income tax checkoff.
Move the bill.
Second.
Aye.
Right.
An act to amend the real property tax law in relation to authorizing the Commissioner of Taxation and Finance to develop, in consultation with the Director of the New York State Direct Division of Veterans Affairs, a listing of documents to be used to establish veterans' eligibility for certain property tax exemptions.
This is becoming a serious issue in localities when a individual does not have a DD-214 form. Sometimes they have not been able to get one, and this would allow other documentation on that so that they could get the tax.
Good question. Why don't they have it?
Certain veterans, if you were in certain lines of services, will that never provide you with a DD-214 form, even though they provided it. They have honorable discharge papers. There's a number of different services that they would not got it in the DD-214 form. Was not originally given to National Guard members. It is today, but it wasn't in the past, and they are eligible under this.
So this is previous old National Guard, basically. National
There's
Guard.
Also certain other members, if you've got a general discharge, in under, even though it was under honorable conditions, mm-hmm. you didn't get a DD-214 prior to Vietnam War. There are certain individuals that don't
get I know, and I went to get my DD-214. It was actually during the campaign because they were trying to play games. And I was able to get expedited because I knew somebody, but it could have been, they said it could have taken up 6 months to a year. So even if you can get your DD-214, it may be better, it may be good to allow some of those other documents.
Okay. And this does not waive any of the other requirements that you have to meet for to get the tax exemption. It's just your proof on the fact that you meet those requirements.
Okay. Cool.
This bill has passed the Senate.
Move the bill.
Move the bill.
Second. All in favor? Opposed? Okay. 5279. By the way, my motion is moved in second or backwards in this script, so.
Great, 1-0.
Take out the whole list.
Were we talking 279?
We're starting on 5279.
Yes, 4810, I'm sorry, Senator Gibson.
Okay. So we're on 5279.
5279.
An act to amend the real property tax law in relation to granting municipalities the authority to provide real property tax exemption for Cold War veterans.
Questions on that?
Okay.
Second. All in favor? Opposed? Senator Parker.
Hey, Senator.
How are you, man?
How's everything?
Good, how are you?
No, you've been here watching.
Just seeing how professionals do it, that's all.
5981.
An act to amend the education law in relation to enacting the New York CARES Act. This bill will give course credit to military servicemen and women that have been serving in active duty overseas who have returned home to seek further education. This bill would encourage service members and veterans to attend academic institutions fully accredited by the New York State Board of Regents.
I'm against this bill.
Just Senator Martin.
Yeah, just, it's a great bill.
I knew I should be king.
Senator Parker, you want to talk to it, or?
No.
Move the bill. Second?
Second.
All in favor? Opposed? Going to finance. 6292, Senator Versani.
An act to amend the education law in relation to awarding high school diplomas to veterans and repealing certain provisions of such law regarding thereto. Operation Recognition currently allows World War II, Korean, and Vietnam veterans to receive the high school diplomas. This legislation will just expand it to cover all veterans.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? 6486, Senator Larkin.
An act to amend the military law in relation to pay for military duty covering 40 work days or 60 calendar days.
Questions on that?
Move the bill.
Second.
Second. Okay, all in favor?
Senator Gibson with that, right?
Opposed? Going to finance.
Our next.
Senator Gibson having a bad day? Hope he gets something going. Wake up on the wrong side of the bed. 6762, by Senator Flanagan.
An act to amend the military law and the public health law in relation to enacting the Veterans Long-Term Care Access Act.
Okay. Questions on that?
Move the bill.
Thank you, second. All in favor?
Senator Gibson.
Opposed? Very good.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, everyone.
Make sure to reach out.
Sure, I'll reach out.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Senator.
Thank you.